Hello guys, this is Igun, and I'm gonna do a tutorial to start with World of Tanks. I know I'm not the first one, nor the best one, but I'm just gonna try to do my best. If you start what, you will see this in your garage. You got a lot of different countries: Chinese, France, German, English, American, and of course the USSR, the Russian. For every country you start with one tank. Obviously they're tier 1, level 1. Which tank should you choose? Well, that depends. First, the Chinese, they are the newest. They have only one line to start with. And from tier 6 and 7 they have different lines. The French, German, American and Russian have multiple lines. The English is also one of the newer and also have less lines. So what country shall you take? Well, that depends. The Chinese are good for their heavy tanks and their light tanks. The French are good for also for their light tanks and for their heavy tanks. Germans, the artillery, the DDs, the heavy tanks, and this is the newest line of the Germans, and a lot of people think they are great medium tanks. The English have really good medium tanks, this line, and very well armored tank destroyers. Americans are good for their tank destroyers and heavy tanks, and also for their medium tanks. The Russians are really good with their heavy tanks and their tank destroyers. Some people say their artillery is really good. I don't know, I'm only at tier 3, I'm not really going that line. But a lot of people say they have really great artillery. So now you still don't know what country to choose. Well, first of all, I will explain what everything is. You have artillery, heavy tanks, medium tanks, light tanks, and tank destroyers. Heavy tanks are the carriers of a game. They lead attacks, they have a lot of hit points. They have most of the time they have also a lot of armor, so they can absorb a lot of damage. Like I said, they are the ones leading attack. Then you have the medium tanks. Medium tanks can work on their own at the end of a game, or in cooperation with a heavy tank. Tank destroyers are the sneaky type. They can do a lot of damage, but they don't have much armor or much hit points, so you try to search a good place and then snipe or ambush other tanks. Light tanks are scouts at the beginning of a game and can look for lonely heavies at the end. Then, last but not least, you have artillery. Artillery are long-range guns. They don't come in close combat. Well, they should not come in close combat because they're only effective at long range. I started with artillery, I like it a lot, but I really like heavies a little bit more. So what shall you choose? Yeah, you can choose yourself. Do you want to lead attacks? Do you want to scout? Do you want to be artillery, long range? You have to find out. For the starter tanks over here, you can choose some different. You have the most of them are the same, except the English. All these tanks are light tanks. Well, this one is a medium tank. With me, all these tanks are elite because I researched everything all. So the except from the English, they all are light tanks. There are, well, most of them are equal, but the Lichtentractor or LOL Tractor and the T1 Cunningham are the two best. You will see pros play with these two tanks because they think they are the best. Which one will you be the best in? Well, you have to find out. I was good with the T1 Cunningham and with the Lichtentractor. Not so good with the others. With their two Renaults, I'm not good because they are too slow. Same reason I'm not really good with this one. He has a lot of hit points, but he's really, really slow. Same with the MS1, he's slow, but is one of the best damage dealers of them in stock. I like the T1 Cunningham the most of all the tier ones. So, yeah, which one shall you choose? Well, I don't know. The only thing I can do is show you some games. Jumped into my T1. Like you can see, it's not a tier 1 battle, but most of the tanks are tier 2, so this will be hard. You see, here I'm going into a bush. Why should I do that? Because if you're in a behind a bush, the enemy you will spot the enemy before they spot you. I'm gonna speed this a little bit up. I'm relocating because I see there are only two tanks over here. And there are also two tanks, but this one, PZ-35T, is a really good tank, so I relocate to help these guys. I was shooting the T-18 at the place where he last was because even though we can't see him anymore, that doesn't mean he relocated. So it could be I still headed him. Here I see this T1E6 and I think I can handle it. So I go for it. At this point I forgot there was another tank. Here on this map you can see where the enemy is last spotted. Now you see he's here, he's shooting me. Now I'm using this guy in front of me for cover, but it didn't work out well because there is enemy on the hill. Here you see I'm dead in a few seconds. This time I took my L tractor, Lichtentractor, and this time it is a tier 1 battle. So let's see if we can do some damage. I'm gonna speed it up till we see some action. You can see the most enemy tanks will go for this place because if you control this island, you can basically shoot over here, over here, over here. So most of the time, the team that controls the island wins. I say most of the times, sometimes it can work out otherwise. You see in stock, this tank is not really fast. But if you have the best engine on best tracks, you are reasonably fast. Gonna speed it up a little. Oh. Here see me shooting at these guys. Unfortunately, I missed the shot. Hit. And here you have the MS1. You can see on the left that I took 42 damage in this shot. That's what the Russians are. A lot of damage in one shot. The disadvantage of the Russians are they have a long reloading time. Here I see the MS1 is coming back, so I try to retreat. I evaded a shot of the L tractor. Unfortunately, I didn't see this T1 coming for me. So, up to the next replay. Here you see me in the FT-17, the French tank. This map, province, you will see a lot in low level, tier 1, tier 2, maybe even tier 3 games, but if you reach tier 4, 5, 6, 7 and higher, you will never see it. Only in low tier battles you see this map. I'm gonna speed it a little bit up, because this is boring. Here I am on normal speed. You see this tank isn't really fast. It's really hard to get over these little hills. Speed it up a little bit. The thing I do over here isn't really smart. Here I just tried to shoot that one. Again, it's not because we can't see him anymore that he is moved, so I keep shooting it, maybe I hit. But you see the bullets explode on the ground, so you see the I miss. So I'm moving up again. This is something I should not have done. I'm going in the open. If I'm spotted now, every tank on over here can shoot me. So far, so good. You can see this L tractor is shooting me, but he hasn't done much damage. Unfortunately, I missed this T1 two times, but I think he's reloading. I bet I'm on fire. So again, I attack the T1, I miss one shot, two shot, my third shot hits its engine. Because I hit his engine, he's on fire. If you're on fire, you lose every tenth of a second some hit points. You see here the T1 and the L tractor with their really fast guns that they killed me in less than a second. So, up to the next. Here you see me in the NC-31, the Chinese one. You see, he really looks like the Frenchman. There's the Frenchman. Here I am. Not much of a difference. That's because the Chinese stole this tank from the French and improved it. You see, first I'm going this way, because I'm thinking I'm going on a hill. I see there are already two guys on a hill, so I'm coming this way. I'm using this rubble for a little bit of protection while I'm shooting the guys over there. I can't see much of the MS1, so I relocate. So I use again a little bit of rubble for protection, and if you noticed, I'm gonna slow it down. I'm reloading. The L tractor behind me is shooting him, but I shoot one shot in him and I kill him. You will see. Boom. He's dead. He still has 26 of 25 hit points left, but he's dead. Why is that? I killed his last crew member. You can see over here I have two crew members, a driver and a commander. If both of them are dead, I can't steer my tank anymore. And then you're dead, even if your tank has full hit points. So here you can see I'm back up. And I see this MS1 and reaction. I fire, I kill him. Over here you see the T1 attacking the already dead tank. And now I'm just trying to get another shot in it. I'm aiming. And I miss. I'm aiming and reloading, and the T1 is coming in front of it. So I'm not shooting because if you hit the Ella, you have to pay a lot of money. So we won. This is a nice little tank of the Chinese. I really like the Chinese light tanks, but there are people who don't like it because they have little gun depression. What's gun depression? Well, gun depression is how low you can put this gun. Can you put it like this or even lower? With the Chinese, you can put it a little low, while with the French you can put it like this, way lower. That's gun depression. I hope I helped some guys out with this, and see you later.